I'm thrilled to share with you how easily I managed to start tracking my Apple Watch with Home Assistant so I can make better and more useful home automations. Same steps can be done to track iPhones and other iOS devices, so if you want to do the same, no worries. Here is a step-by-step guide for you. Before we start this journey, let's first talk why Apple Watch and iOS devices are a bit different than the other Bluetooth devices that you can track easily. It is all because of a technology called Resolvable Private Addresses, or RPA for short. Think of RPAs as your device hammer-long cloak. Instead of revealing a fixed Bluetooth addresses that could be exploiting for tracking by well-intentioned and not so well-intentioned people, RPAs continuously shuffle your device MAC address. This dynamic feature is a significant step forward in protecting your privacy, and vendors like Apple are using it in their devices. For good or for bad, this RPA feature prevents tracking your own devices with Home Assistant, for example. And tracking your devices can be very beneficial, as you will be able to make numerous useful home automations and security enhancements, like turning on and off lights based on your presence, voice announcements, automatic climate control, arming and disarming alarms, you name it. Everything is possible. Having in mind that we are always carrying our phones or smartwatches with us, at least I am, means tracking these personal devices is a clear indicator, are you home or not, and even how far away from home are you. But more on that later, as now it is time to talk about some requirements that are needed for this project to become a reality. First thing that is needed is an Apple Watch or some other iOS device like iPhone or iPad with a Bluetooth enabled. I will use my scratched but still working good Apple Watch Series 6, for example. Next thing that is needed is working Home Assistant. If you don't have Home Assistant yet, why are you still waiting? Go get one, it is free and can save you money and time. If you need more help with the Home Assistant, then please register for my free webinar, where I'll talk about different Home Assistant installation types, their pros and cons, as well as one super simple way to get started on a PC in under 5 minutes. And as I said, it is all free. Final thing that is needed is to get your device Identity Resolving Key, or IRK for short. To get this, you need a device running macOS like MacBook, iMac, Mac Mini, and so on. I'm not quite sure if getting this Apple device key is possible on Windows, and if you have more info about that, please share it in the comments. So, here is how I obtained my Apple Watch Identity Resolving Key, or IRK. I will follow these instructions here for private BLE devices. In the Home Assistant documentation, I'm running macOS. If you're using Windows, I don't know how you can do that. Maybe you'll tell me in the comments. And these are the steps that I'm about to follow. I'm using same iCloud account on both my MacBook and my Apple Watch. I'll start the Spotlight search and I'll search for keychain access. I'll open it. I'll select this open keychain access. I'll select iCloud and I'll search for Bluetooth. And here I'll sort the results by keychain and I'll look only for keychains that are inside iCloud. And I'll start with this first one. I believe this is the correct one. And as you can see here on the account field, I have a public MAC address. Now I have to compare this MAC address with the MAC address of my Apple Watch. I'll go to my settings. I'll select general, about. I'll scroll down and this is my Bluetooth address. It ends with 75A1. 75A1, this is the same device. So this is what I need. I'll click on this show password. I'll type my macOS password here. I'll click on this field and I'll select all text here by clicking on Command A, then I'll copy this and I'll paste it on a new text file. And this is it, remote IRK. This is the key, this is the data, and the data is the encoded IRK key. I'll copy this and I'll go to my Home Assistant. Once I have the key, adding my Apple Watch inside Home Assistant using private BLE device was a seamless experience. Here, I'll press the C button to invoke this command search bar and I'll type integrations. Then I'll select navigate integrations. I'll add new one. I'll search for private Bluetooth low energy device. And I'll paste the IRK key that I copied earlier. Then I'll click on submit. And success, I successfully added a private BLE device in my Home Assistant. I'll click finish. This is my new device. I can click on it. In addition, I can show whether my Apple device is within the border of my home or exploring the world outside. And currently the estimated distance is 0 meters. This is estimated distance from my Bluetooth receiver. In my case, I'm using Bluetooth proxies. I did some tests before and as you can see from the history, these updates are happening every 5 minutes or something. Because now I'm exactly next to my Bluetooth proxy, the distance is 0 meters. But I'll try to go far away and we'll see if this is going to be changed. Using this method, it is possible to see an estimation of the distance between my Apple Watch and the nearest Bluetooth dongle or proxy, along with its signal strength. Three entities are not shown. I'll try to enable them to see if there is anything useful here. I'll enable the first one. This is the estimated broadcast interval. I'll enable the power as well. It will take up to 30 seconds for these sensors to become available. Okay, let's see what will happen. I'll refresh this. Actually, I removed my smartwatch and I'm not sure what is going to happen now. Oh, here it is. The estimated broadcast interval is 6.7 seconds. That's pretty good. The power is 9 decibel meters and signal strength is minus 86. Okay, and estimated distance is now 0.6 meters. Great! It seems that it is working because currently my Apple Watch is not with me. Now I can try to make some home automations. For example, if the estimated distance is between 0 and 0.5 meters, activate some lights or something. It doesn't matter. Everything is possible. I just got back from the outside. I finished the workout. And I also tested this sensor. I was about 15 meters away from the Bluetooth receiver, but the estimated distance sensor is showing 1.5 meters away. So if you add a zero at the end, it should be probably accurate. Also, the update interval is not so often. I cannot catch how much time it takes to update. So a summary, this is not a very reliable method, at least for me, for a presence detection. You can use this as a secondary check or something in your automations, but again, it's not very reliable as a primary device for presence detection. I'm interested to see your results. Please share them in the comments as well as your devices that you're trying to track. Overall, this integration is working, but probably due to the Bluetooth low energy protocol, the updates and distance are not so accurate. Again, that's according to my tests. Share your thoughts in the comments. Thanks for watching. I'm Kirill and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!